Hello dear students, welcome to Arjun English School. I hope you all are doing very well. And now today I am going to start one chapter in statistics for 11th standard. The name of chapter is function. Okay, so here chapter number 8, function. Weightage of marks is around for 6 marks. And here first of all, we need to understand the basic meaning of function and its terminology. So here, first of all, definition. If A and B are any two non-empty cells, and each element of set A is related with one and only one element of set B by some rule, relation or correspondence, then it is called a function from set A to set B and is denoted by F, G, H, K, etc. Means we can say that there are two kind of sets, set A and set B. Now set A, all the elements of set A are correlated with set B by any some rules, relation or correspondence. So we can say that both set are interconnected with each other. So it is called function. Now which kind of interconnection? It may include some rules, regulations, relations or correspondence, etc. Now function can be, generally function is denoted by F, okay, but it can be denoted by G, H, K, etc. Okay, so this is called basic meaning of function. Now here there is one illustration, but before starting this illustration, I want to clarify something. That is, here you can say that, you can see that A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Means in one function, there are four elements. In second function, it is 3, 5, 7, 9. Means again, four elements in second function. Now, main function equation is F of x is equals to 2x plus 1, where x belongs to A. Okay. So here understand, here two sets A and B are given. So first set, that is A. So set A, which we call domain. What? Domain. While another set, that is set B, which we call codomain. So again, it is domain, set A is called domain and set B is called codomain. And here is, it is a function equation, that is 2x plus 1. Now they ask for verify whether the relation between the elements of sets given below are function or not. So let us, we are checking about it. First of all, in every question, they have provided the function where in every function, we have to put the value of domain. Okay, what? Domain. So here the function is f of x is equals to 2x plus 1. But in this function, we have to put the value of domain, that is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So instead of x, here in this equation, instead of x, we have to just put a value 1, 2, 3 and 4. And there are 4 answers. Okay. So let us check answers. Here, this is the function equation in which we are putting the value of domain. X is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4. Where value of x is equals to 1. Then 2 in bracket 1 plus 1 is equals to 3. Then if we put the value 2, then instead of x it is 2. So 2 into 2, 4, 4 plus 1, 5, then 7 and then 9. Here, for each element of set A, there exists only one element in set B. Okay, here you can see that in B, the elements are 3, 5, 7 and 9. Whereas our answer is again same 3, 5, 7, 9. So we can say that each element of set A, there exists one and only one element in set B. That is, each element of set A is related with one and only one element of set B by the relation 2x plus 1. Hence, 2x plus 1 is a function. Understood? So there is one another sum that you can see here. In this question, they provided that domain P is equals to minus 1 by 2, 0 and 1, while codomain S is equals to 10. Now, K of X is equals to 10. Here, K of X is a function. So in this function, we have to put the value of domain, that is minus 1 by 2, 0 and 1. But here you can see that in this function, there is no value of x. And that's why for every value of domain, answer remains 10. Why? Because in this function equation, there is no x at all. And that's why we cannot put the value of x here. And that's why for each values of domain, for each values of this function equation, if we are putting the values of domain, our answer remains 10. And here the codomain value is again 10. So it means we can say that for every value of function equation, we got the value for codomain, that is 10. Understood? So it is a function. So these kinds of examples 1, 2, 3, 4. It is not so important for your exam. And as I have explained you about domain and codomain, okay? If two sets are given, then first set is called domain and second set is called codomain. Understood? Then after, there is another point, that is range. So what is range? Range is denoted by RF. Okay? Range is denoted by RF. And how can we find this? Again, in every function equation, we have to put the values of domain. So we got the range. Let us see one example. Illustration number 2, where they ask to find out obtain domain, codomain and range for the following functions. Now, you can see that in this question, there are, in this illustration 2, there are 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 questions are given. We are solving one by one. We are starting with question 1, where function equation, that is A lies to B, where A is equals to minus 1, 0, 1. B is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, F of X is equals to 2x plus 5. Now remember one thing, they asked to find out domain. As earlier we discussed about the domain and codomain, you can simply see that the value of domain is a set A, that is A is equals to minus 1, 0 and 1, and hence the answer of domain is equals to A is equals to minus 1, 0 and 1. Second, they ask to find out codomain. So here in the value of codomain, we can say that this is codomain, that is second set, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is B. So you can see here domain value is minus 1, 0 and 1, while the value of codomain is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is that clear? Now, they also ask to find out the range. Now, If we want to find out the value of rain, then these in function equation, we have to put the values of domain. So function equation is 2x plus 5. So this is the function equation in which we have to put the values of domain. So domain value is minus 1, 0 and 1. So in this equation, we are putting the values of minus 1, 0 and 1. So in first of all, 2x plus 5. So instead of x, we are putting the value minus 1. Then in second one, instead of x, we are putting the value 0. And again, instead of x, we are putting the value of 1. So first of all, minus 1, then after 0 and 1. Means these three values, that is of domain, minus 1, 0 and 1. So if I am solving this, then 2 into minus 1, that is minus 2. Minus 2 plus 5, we got the answer 3. Second equation, 2 into 0 means 0. 0 plus 5, answer is 5. In third domain equation, 2 into 1, 2. And 2 plus 5, answer is 7. It means, here it is these three values, that is the answer of range. So range that we called RF, and the value of RF is equals to 3, 5 and 7. So here you can see that range is equals to RF, and value of range, that is 3, 5 and 7. Simple. So overall this chapter is very simple. Okay, so first of all, this is the first method that where we have completed the topic of domain, codomain and range. Okay, so we are solving more extra sums for your practice purpose. Here there is second question where A is equals to minus 1, 2, 3 and 4, whereas g of x is equals to 3x plus 5. And here the function equation g said a lies to n. It means a is a domain, n is a codomain. So the answer of domain is minus 1, 2, 3 and 4. And codomain is n. But in this case, there is no any elements of n is given. So simply we just have to write down like codomain, that is B, is equals to n. Okay. And now the last part is to find out the value of range. So g of x is equals to 3x plus 5. So instead of x, we have to put the values of domain minus 1, 2, 3 and 4. So instead of x, 4 values, minus 1, 2, 3 and 4, that you can see here. Okay, so now we are solving one by one. First of all, if answer is minus 1, if the value is minus 1, 3 multiplied by minus 1, minus 3. Minus 3 plus 5, 2. Second, instead of x, it is 2. So 3 to the 6, 6 plus 5, 11. Then third element is 3. 3 to the 9, 9 plus 5, 14. And last 4, 3 to the 12, 12 plus 5, 17. Understood? So this is the question of domain, codomain and range. Now again, question number 3 and question number 4 that you have to solve for your own practice purpose, where you can see that this is the domain P and elements are minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. Codomain is S, the elements are 4, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. And function equation is H of X is equals to X minus 2. And last one, where A belongs to Z, where A is equals to minus 1 by 2, 0, 1 by 2, and k codomain is z, and function equation k of x is equals to 4x square plus 3. Okay, now so here there is a new topic, that is types of function, where you can see that there are three types of function here, that is one function, many one function, constant function. So this question can be asked for 1 marks for how many types of function, and one another question, that is define one question or define many one function or define constant function. Okay, so let us start with the one function, where suppose function where a belongs to b, it for any two different elements of domain A, their images or functional values are different, the function f is called one function. It means if there are two different elements in domain and answer of domains are two different answers, if I am putting the value of domain in function equation and there are two separate values, then it is called one function. Understood? Let us see this example, that if value of x is equals to minus 2, then we got the answer 0. Value for minus 1, answer is 1, and value of 0, answer is 2. It means you can see that here in this function equation we put the values these 3 and we got these 3 answers 0, 1 and 2, and no any two common values are there, and that's why it is called one function. Means if I am putting values in function equation and I got different answer for different values, means we can say that no two values are same. Okay, so it is called one function. Here there is a diagram for one function, where you can see that this is a set A and this is set B, and here you can see that if I am putting the value of A1, we got the answer function of A1, and if it is A2, we got different answer, that is function of A2. So it is called one function. Next one, many one function, where suppose function of A belongs to B, if for any two different elements of domain A, their images or functional values are same. Most important, for different elements of domain, we got any two answers are as a same answer, then it is called many one function. Understood? In one function, all values are different, all answers are different. But in many one function, if any two answers are same, then it becomes the many one. Again, here there is an example. Here there are 4 values. Minus 2, minus 1, 1 and 2. These are the values of domain. And if I am putting in this equation, we got 4 answers. This one. 5, 2, 2 and 5. It means we can say that any two values are same. Let's say here 5 are same or 2 are same. So these types of answer are same. So it is called many one function. Again, here there is a diagram where you can see that 4 elements in set A and 4 elements in set B. For elements of A1 and A2, answer is same. For elements A3 and A4, though answers are different, but here answers are same for elements A1 and A2. Okay. So it is called many one function. Again, I am revising it. In one function, for all the values of domain, we got separate answers. So it is one function. And for all the values of different domain, for domain, we got any two answers as the same. So we can call it as a many one function. And last one, constant function. So what is a constant function? Here, if for each element of domain A, the images or functional values is same, the function F is called constant function. Means for all values of domain, we got same answer. So it is called constant function. For all the elements of domain, we got the same answer, that is called constant function. Again, here there is an example where you can see that here there are three values, that is 1, 2, 3. But if I am receiving the same answer like 5, again 5, then it is called constant function. In this diagram, you can see that there are three values, A, B, and C. But for every three values, you got the same answer. This is called constant function. So again, there are three types of function: one function, many one function, and constant function. Where all the values are different, we call one function. Where any two values are same, we can call it as a many one function. Where all the values are same, we can call it as a constant function. Understood? Okay. So here there is illustration number 7, where you can see that if function is equals to n to n, where f of x is equals to x square and g is equals to z less 0 to n, where g of x is equals to x square. Now, can we say that f and g are equal function? Here you can see that function f of x is equals to x square. Function g of x is equals to x square. So you can see that here the function is same. But let us check domain and codomain. Domain of function f, that is a, is equals to n, means this is the domain and this is the codomain, where for function g it is the domain z and codomain is n. So here we can say that domains are different, and that's why both functions are not equal function, even if their function equation is same. Understood? Next. Here in illustration number 9, function of a to b, where f of x is equals to 1 minus 4x, g to a to c, g of x is equals to 6x plus 1, and a is equals to 0, 1, and 2. Are f and g equal functions? Now let us check the answer. Here, for function f of x, equation is 1 minus 4x. Now, put the value that is 0 and 1. So, if I am put here 0, so instead of x, it is 0. So, 4 into 0, 0. And 1 minus 0, answer is 1. Then after, we are putting the value 1. So here, instead of x, value 1. 4 ones are 4. And 1 minus 4, answer is minus 3. And again, you can put the value for 2. They have not provided here, but you can put the value x is equals to 2 here. Okay, so it is for the f of x. Now compare it with g of x. So g of x is equals to 6x plus 1, where first of all we are putting the value 0, then after 1, then after 2. So instead of x, if I am putting here 0, so 6 into 0, 0, 0 plus 1, answer is 1. Then after 6 into 1, 6, and 6 plus 1, answer is 7. So here you can see that answer is 1 and minus 3, whereas under g of x, answer is 1 and 7. So here function of f1 is not equals to g of 1, means you can see that f of 0 and g of 0 values, when we are putting 0 instead of x, we got the same answer. But if we are putting 1 in f of x and g of x function equation, we got two different values. And hence we can say that f and g are not equal function. Understood? So now, this is the one another topic, that is real function. Here in real function, it is very simple, and these types of questions that you already studied in standard 8, 9, 10. Here you can see that f of x is equals to x cube plus 1 divided by x square minus 2x plus 1. And we have to find the value of f minus 2, f minus 1, and f of 0. Now, it means instead of x, in this is the full function equation. So instead of x, we can put the value minus 2, minus 1, and 0. So let us check. Here, instead of x, first of all, we have put minus 2, then minus 1, and then 0. Okay. So first of all, if I am writing here minus 2 cube plus 1 divided by minus 2 square minus 2 minus 2 plus 1, then our answer is cube of minus 2 minus 8 plus 1 divided by square of minus 2, 4. If there is any negative value, and if I am doing a square of any value, then answer is positive. Okay, because the square is an even number and hence it is positive. So square of minus 2 is plus 4. Minus 2 and minus 2, multiplication of these two, we got the answer plus 4 and plus 1. So minus 8 plus 7 plus 1, answer minus 7. And 4 plus 4 plus 1, final answer is minus 7 divided by 9. Next one. If I am putting the value minus 1 instead of x. So here minus 1 cube plus 1 divided by minus 1 square minus 2 minus 1 plus 1. So here minus 1 cube minus 1 plus 1 in denominator square of minus 1, that is plus 1 minus minus plus 2 plus 1. So in numerator minus 1 plus 1 becomes 0, in denominator 1 plus 2 plus 1 4. So here the value in numerator is 0, so our final answer is 0. Now third time we have to put the value 0 instead of x. So let us check. 0 cube plus 1 divided by 0 square minus 2 in bracket 0 plus 1. So 0 cube, no value. So in numerator there is only 1. In denominator square of 0, no value. 2 multiplied by 0, no value. So here in denominator it is only 1. So 1 divided by 1, we got the answer 1. That's it. So here the equation that is provided in the equation, and in this equation we just have to put the values and solve the sum. That's it. Understood? So again, there are many sums for your practice. I am solving one another sum for your practice purpose. Here f of x is equals to x cube plus 3 raised to x minus x square minus 2 raised to x. Find f of 3 minus 6 f of 2. So now this is the function where instead of x we have to put the value just 3. So 3 cube plus 3 cube minus square of 3 minus cube of 2. So 27 plus 27 minus 9 minus 8. Answer 37. So here the value of f of 3 that we have find out. Now full concentrate here. They asked about 6 in multiplication of f of 2. So first of all, we are finding the value of f of 2, then multiplied the answer with 6. So here, this is the function equation where we are putting the value 2 instead of x. So again, here 2 cube plus 3 square minus 2 square minus 2 square. So 2 cube is 8, 3 square 9, 2 square 4, 2 square 4. My answer is 9. But remember one thing, this answer is only for f of 2. But in the question, they asked you for 6 multiplication of f of 2. So now this answer must be multiplied with 6. So here you can see that in this equation I am putting the values f of 3 value is 37, f of 2 value is 9, and multiplication it by 6 as provided in the equation. Now 6 9s are 54, here 37, and 37 minus 54, our answer is 17. So this is the illustration 11. Understood? Then after, in illustration number 13, you can see that if f of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 8, then for which value of x is f of 2x is equals to 2 f of x. Now here f of x is equals to x square minus 4x plus 8. This is the function equation where instead of x the value is 2x. So here instead of x we have to put the value 2x. So instead of x square it is 2x square. Instead of x it is 2x plus 8. So 2x whole square is equals to 4x square. Then 4 into 2, 8x plus 8. So f of 2x is equals to 4x square minus 8x plus 8. This is the value of f of 2x. Now in opposite side they asked about 2f of x. So here f of x must be multiplied by 2. So it becomes, the whole values are multiplied by 2. So here it becomes 2x square. If here I am multiplied with 2, answer is 8x. And if here I am multiplied with 2, answer is 16. Now I am writing this equation and put the value according to it. So this is the equation at here, and f of 2x, that is value 4x square minus 8x plus 8, this is here that you can see, is equals to here the function f of x, I have multiplied it with 2. So here it is 2x square minus 8x plus 16. So now just simplify with the use of maths, where here 4x square, here 2x square, it goes into the opposite side, the remaining value is 2x square. Here it is minus 8x, goes into the opposite side, it becomes the plus 8x, minus 8x plus 8x cancel, then here plus 8, here plus 16, plus 16 goes into the opposite side, it becomes the minus 16. So 8 minus 16, it answer is minus 8, is equals to 0. So here they have written down the direct answer, but I have explained how they have solved this. So 2x square minus 8 is equals to 0. So now here the common factor is 2, that is in both this side I have divided it by 2, or we can say that common factor 2. So here 2 removes, then answer is x square, 8 divided by 2, 4, and 0 remains as it is. So x square minus 4 is equals to 0. Now this minus 4 goes into the opposite side, so it becomes the x square is equals to 4. And if x square is equals to 4, under root of 4, it becomes 2. But remember one thing, if I am doing the square of plus 2, then also it is 4. And if I am doing the square of minus 2, then answer is also plus 4. So if I am doing the under root of 4, then it may be plus or it may be minus. So here this sign is necessary, that is x is equals to plus minus 2. So if I am not putting this sign, then at the time of paper checking, your half marks can be deducted for these silly mistakes. Okay, so remember one thing, whenever we are doing the under root, then at that time we have to put the sign of plus or minus. Understood? So here we have completed all the illustration part, and from the next class I'm going to start some extra sums from your exercise 8. Okay, so from the next class I'm going to start a board work for your these extra sums, that is for find the value of x, f of x, what is domain, codomain and range, as well as types of function, one one, many one and constant function. Okay, so see you in the next class. Thank you.